Hey, it's Fran again. This time I'm at my favorite place probably in Philadelphia ever since I was a kid. I've been coming here, the Franklin Institute, named after Benjamin Franklin, and really just a cathedral to science in Philadelphia. And I wanted to give a really quick little tour of this place to show you the highlights, the things that I really like. Although it's a very big museum sort of place where, I mean, if you come here, you can spend all day easily, but I'm going to give you the highlights. Just a quick walkthrough, a sample, if you will, of things you find here at the Franklin Institute. Let's go take a look. First lightning rod. Oh, this is so hard to see. Oh yeah. Ben Franklin's electrostatic generator. Kind of see the crank on that. Glass ball. Ooh. Dangerous. Franklin's tube. Static electricity tube. Franklin's bells. Blinky lights. Giant walk through heart. Used to walk through this when I was a kid. I'm a little big to get in it now. It's a bit cramped for someone of my size, but you get kind of stuck in the aorta. Yeah, the walk through heart. This was a huge thing in the 70s. The kids still love it today, I'm glad to say. Getting vertigo. I'm in the grand staircase. The Space Command Center. Space. The final frontier. Oh yeah. Gonna touch the meteor. Ooh. Primordial. The oldest thing you'll ever touch. The meteor crater. Yep. 4 billion years old. Touch the mojo. Right. Right. Courtesy of astronaut Dave Scott, Apollo 15. go. Genuine moon rock. See, it's been cut from a larger sample.
Sarah's leaving.
Look at that. That is moon rock right there. The real thing. So close you could almost touch it. Look, I'm holding the moon rock. These are Apollo tools that were used for training, but they're the same tools that they took to the moon. So this is interesting. This is the tool they used to clean the cameras. It had a little magnifying lens there on the bottom. It's a magnifier and a brush to clear off the camera lenses. It's also got a little hardened tool on the end. Right there, like a carbide tip tool for scribing. So, yeah, like a multi-tool. That they use to determine the soil depth. It's got markers on it and a pointy tip. I've seen them carry that thing around in the videos. I never knew what it was, but that's what it is. It's to detect the depth of the soil. Cool. Alright, well, if I were 6 years old again, I would be killing for that Apollo 11 spacesuit outfit. I'll tell you. I did have a space helmet though, so I shouldn't complain. Helmet mug. Apollo 11 hat. Yeah. That's cool too. Oh yeah. Time to blast off. You know it. Maybe if I'm really good, Santa will bring me a Saturn V Lego kit. Maybe. Who knows? It's a geek paradise. Ooh. I love puzzles. Love puzzles. Mm. I had one of these pyramid things when I was a kid. The alternative to the Rubik's Cube. Very easy to solve. Too easy, probably. Oh. Gotta have astronaut ice cream. Unfortunately, I can't eat it anymore because of my lactose outrage. Ooh, astronaut fruit. Ho ho. Astronaut bananas. Ho ho. Yes. Gyroscopes. Mmm. I had one of these when I was a kid too. Ooh, moon pillow. Ooh. Moon pillow. Mmm. Cratery. Ooh, brain bag. Brains. 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 Gotta give props to the man himself. Ben Franklin stuff. Yep. Lots of Ben Franklin stuff. Too cool for British rule. Although, if you read the autobiography of Ben Franklin, he was actually very proud to consider himself British until King George did all that stuff, and then he, you know, became arguably the very first American, which is the title of another great book about him called First American. Highly recommend it. I gotta find out if I'm in someone else's dream or not. Am I in my own dream, or am I in someone else's dream? Alright. My favorite part, the amazing machine, which contains the object in the museum that I am most familiar with. It's basically where they have all the clockworks and machinery. A lot of it is running in the other room, making all that noise. Very first typewriter, Hammond number 1. It's probably not what you think of when you think of a typewriter, but that's how it started out. Not very ergonomic, but it works.
Ah. There's some showing video of the gearworks of the automaton. So in this exhibit they have lots of things you can do that just show all the various principles of mechanics, leverage and gearworks and cams and all kinds of stuff. There's my friend Andy Barron.
And Andy Barron are responsible for bringing it to life and keeping it running.
Yeah. Andy is the guy.
We think of robots as moving in very mechanical ways, very jerky motions. This machine, far and away, is the most elegant in its movement.
Yeah. My friend Andy, he's the guy who is responsible for bringing me Mailer Day Automaton back to life. He spent so many years.
Four very detailed drawings and three poems, two in French.
I'll put links in the description for my various videos on
the
automaton.
He has the most
automaton.
Extensive mechanical memory of the known automaton. Yeah.
Maillard automaton that I have lovingly nicknamed Bob. All of his workings. Hopefully we'll get a chance to spend some more time with Bob and do more work. I got to finish up a prototype for the working pen. And there's a lot of other pending work on this machine that we had plans to do for years, so here's hoping that we can get the time and the access to do that in the near future. All right, well, that's it for this one. A really quick look at the Franklin Institute. I'll be back in the lab shortly. See you then.